Hello guys and welcome back to Raising Reef. In today's video we're going to be starting a new tank build series and this is episode 1. We're going to be looking at the tank itself, the stand and how it differs to the tank I've already got. Well, essentially it doesn't differ that greatly. It's exactly the same dimensions, the stand is the same and the tank dimensions are the same. The only real difference between this tank and the tank I already have is it doesn't have any scratches on the glass and the weir setup is different. The weir setup in my current tank has a weir box in the back of the tank which allows water to flow into the weir chamber, and it has two holes drilled in the bottom that have bulkheads that allow the water to drain down into the sump. One is a primary overflow, which has a ball valve on it to restrict it to try and create a silent siphon. And the second one is a secondary overflow, which is an emergency drain in case the first one gets clogged. Other than that, I have a return line coming up over the back of the tank, which is then split into two, which returns the water back into the tank from the sump. This setup is going to be completely different in the fact that I'm going to be using a ghost overflow box. This attaches through two holes that you can probably see drilled into the back of the tank. They are 60mm holes and the return lines are come through two 28mm holes either side of that. The weir box itself is an Eshopps Eclipse L. It's a larger version than I would probably need for this tank, but I like the fact that it's a little bit wider and has a bit of a wider profile in the back of the tank. I think it just looks a little bit nicer than the little box ones that they do in the smaller versions. It can cope with a lot more flow than I want to put through this tank, but having the ability to adjust the flow down to restrict the weir in order to create that siphon means that it doesn't matter about the thickness of the pipes, you can just restrict it as much as you need to create the type of flow that you want. Also, it has three drain lines in the back of the overflow box, which allows me to use one potentially to feed a secondary tank. We'll get into that in a future episode. That's plans I have further down the line. So the stand itself is made of steel. It's steel box frame. It's 30mm by 30mm box frame. It's all been welded seamlessly together. It looks quite nice. I've cut a couple of pieces of MDF, one to sit between the frame itself and the tank, and the other one to create a bottom shelf that the sump will sit on. The MDF is 22mm thick, and I'm going to paint it black. So let's take a closer look at the overflow box and install it on the tank. So this is the Eshopps Eclipse L. I had to order this from America because they don't seem to stock anything like this in the UK. There is one other product that I found that does this job, and I think it's the Reef Synergy, I believe it's called, and it's a very similar product to this. You could argue that it's a better build quality, a bit more design, has got a little bit more design thought's gone into it, but it is considerably more expensive than this one. This one, I had to order it from America. It came shipped to my door all in for about £120, which I thought was pretty good value for money. The other eSynergies version is at least £200, I think, for the unit itself before you ship it. So it's considerably cheaper. And what you get in the box here, it comes with a cutter to cut the glass if you wanted to install it yourself. I personally didn't want to go to the bother of drilling the holes in the tank myself, so I got them drilled when the tank was manufactured. But it does come with that in the box for you to do that if you wish to, if you're installing it onto a tank you already have. It also comes with this, which is a template, which allows you to then position this on the back of your tank to position where you want to drill the holes in order to put the box in the right position. Obviously I didn't need to use this. All I did was draw out a plan of the back of the tank. I measured out where I wanted everything and then I sent that picture to the tank manufacturer and they drilled it accordingly. Well, the second time they did. The first time they drilled the wrong size holes in the back. I did ask for 60mm holes and they drilled them 65mm. That wasn't what I asked for, so they had to replace the back panel and re-drill it. It wasn't a big issue, it's just it did set back the expected delivery time of the tank. Having said that, the second time they did decide to deliver the tank. When it did turn up, The silicon job on the actual tank itself wasn't what I asked for. I asked for minimal silicon, which is quite low profile and looks a lot more sleek and professional. And there was also a big scratch on the front, so we sent that back and they've rectified those. They were very good about it all. I can't fault them in their ability to correct the mistakes that were made. And now the tank is with me and I'm completely happy with the service that I got. Other than that, packed into the box. You get something that looks like this. This is the front section that will fit on the inside of the tank and act as a weir comb to allow the water to drain into this section here, which is quite narrow, which is why they call it a ghost overflow. And then that feeds through the two bulkheads into the back chamber, which has three tank connectors at the bottom, which allow the water to then be drained down into the sump. One is already got a piece of 1-inch PVC pipe already in it, which is designed as the emergency overflow. You can fit that pipe to any part of that you want. That just slits in there, and that sets the water level to stop it from backing up and overflowing the tank in an emergency. The other two, you can set one as a complete siphon, and the other one you can use as an emergency overflow. Like I said, I'm going to use one with a tank connector on it, and I'm going to use that in the future to feed another tank. It also comes with a lid that I nearly broke, and that just sits on top of the back section, like so. So let's fit it to the tank. So according to the instructions, you just take the locking nut off of the bulkheads. And you leave them and the gasket just inside the box. Remove the two boxes apart. Right, according to the instructions, you slip these two bulkheads through the holes. You then attach the two gaskets onto the back of the two protruding bulkheads poking through the glass. You then slot on the other box, add the two remaining gaskets, and add the lock nuts. Once you've got that on a little way, you'll be able to let go of the whole thing and it won't fall apart. Then you just basically hand tighten this till the gaskets make a good seal. Like so. As easy as that. So, see if I can spin this around a little bit. As you can see there, we've got the box attached to the back of the aquarium now. It does protrude out a good 10 mil. So if you were looking to push your aquarium up against a wall, you're going to have to obviously allow for that gap at the back. But then obviously I can run my pipes down and then under the cabinet and then into the sump from there. So I'm hoping that this will be a better solution than the solution that I've got already. It does free up a lot more room in the tank. As you can see here, the overflow box takes up minimal space within the aquarium, which allows a lot more space to be a bit more creative with the rockscape that you do without having to work around what essentially was a big block of a weir that used to stand in the back of my current tank. So I'm looking forward to being a bit more, having a bit more freedom to create a bit of a more interesting scape, maybe a little bit more open than what I've got at the moment, and we'll see how that goes. So that's pretty much as far as we've got at the moment. We've got our tank and we've got our stand. I have got the aquarium plumbing, most of it anyway, in a box in the garage. That's ready to go. I'll do a whole episode on installing all the plumbing, but before we get that far, I need to build the sump. I'm going to build the sump from scratch, repurposing some old glass that was given to me in the form of another tank and a sump from a friend of mine that was going to throw it away, so I decided to give it a go. I'd never built a tank before, so it was going to be a new learning experience for me, so I will document all of that and I will show you how I get one. So following along with this build process is something that interests you, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit the bell notification if you want to be notified of when the new videos come up. I will be documenting each different process in installing this new tank, from one episode about the plumbing, one episode about building the sump, one episode talking about new equipment I'm going to be using. So if that's the sort of thing that you're interested in, don't forget to subscribe. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, share it if you're so inclined, and I'll see you in the next video.